Welcome to La Alta Guajira, Colombia. In this video, the route and the cost of transportation to get to Cabo de la Vela and Punta Gallina. Mi nombre es Aleja Odyssey, Odisea en inglés. Soy una viajera a tiempo completo y me encanta hacer videos. If you are outside of Colombia, try to book your flight directly to Riohacha. You can also travel to Bogota and then from Bogota take a plane to Riohacha or go by bus, but I think the cheapest way will be by flight. I booked my direct flight from Canada to Riohacha for about $900 with United Airlines. Si estás en Colombia, puedes llegar por Riohacha o por Valledupar. Si quieres volar, la aerolínea más barata que encontré es Viva Air. Si estás en cualquier otra ciudad de la costa como Cartagena o Santa Marta, puedes tomar un bus directamente hasta Riohacha. It will be about 3 hours from Santa Marta to Riohacha. The bus is about 30,000 pesos, 30,000 pesos. We got to Riohacha. Now you're in Riohacha, you need to make your way up to Cabo de la Vela. Estamos en este momento en Riohacha y de aquí vamos a tomar un vehículo que nos va a llevar a Uribia. El vehículo te puede costar 15,000 o 17,000 o 20,000. The trip is about 1.5 hours. Very important is that you need to take this car in the early morning, as early as you can. Ask them to drop you in Cuatro Vías de Uribia. Llegamos a Uribia, estamos ahorita esperando un transporte que nos llega al Cabo de la Vela. De aquí al Cabo de la Vela es aproximadamente 1 hora y 45 minutos y cuesta alrededor de 20, 22, 25 mil pesos para llegar allá. Hasta Uribia hay calle pavimentada, de Uribia al Cabo de la Vela es despavimentado. There is also another option that you can do from Uribia. You can take a tour directly from Uribia to Punta Gallina. It includes the transportation from Uribia to Cabo de la Vela, a tour in Cabo de la Vela, then you can sleep in Cabo de la Vela. Next day you go to Punta Gallina, you take a tour in Punta Gallina, but does not include the food and the accommodation in Punta Gallina. I'm gonna give you the contact of the guy I travel with. He is with Huya Tours. As for Edwin Hernandez.
Bueno, de aquí ofrecemos el servicio de alojamiento en chinchorros, hamacas, habitaciones. También ofrecemos los tours aquí en el Cabo de la Vela, Punta Gallinas.
Now you are in Cabo de la Vela. If you don't want to book a tour, then you can go to Cabo de la Vela and find your own accommodation there. Aquí en el Cabo de la Vela, la ranchería, el chinchorro que le llaman, son esas hamaquitas, vale alrededor de 15, 20, 25 mil pesos. Lo mejor del viaje es que en este momento estamos viendo el atardecer. There is many accommodations. If you are on your own, there is Uta. It's really good, it's kind of the best accommodation there. Remember that a hamaca and a chinchorro are different. Hamaca is way smaller and a chinchorro has something that opens and you can cover yourself with that like a blanket. If you want to move around Cabo de la Vela, the motos usually charge you 5,000 pesos. Te cobran 5,000 pesos. Once in Cabo de la Vela, if you wanna keep going and you wanna go to the northest point of South America, Punta Gallina, such a beautiful place, then you have to take a tour. There is no way you can go on your own unless you have your own car and you go with a guide. The trip from Cabo de la Vela to Punta Gallina is about 2 hours, 3 hours, depending on the driver again. Some of them go really fast, that is super scary. Usually they charge you 150 from Cabo de la Vela. They take you to Punta Gallina, they do a tour during the day, you visit 3 places, and then the next day you come back to Cabo de la Vela, but does not include, again, accommodation and food. In Punta Gallina, I stay with a beautiful woman called Victoria. She has a beautiful hostel. I'm gonna leave the information of her hostel here. We paid 20 bucks for a chinchorro, and then the food was about 20 bucks as well. She was amazing. I really, 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 really recommend her. If you go to Punta Gallina, go see Victoria and tell her Aleja sent you.
Yo soy Victoria Ballestero. Invito a todos los turistas que vengan a conocer a Punta Gallina. Acá los vamos a recibir con los brazos abiertos y se van a ir muy contentos.
The best thing about this hostel in Punta Gallina is that you hang out with our YU family.
Van a convivir con nosotros un ratico el tiempo que estén por acá.
I made all my way from Canada to see Punta Gallina and all these beautiful places around. I would love to know in the comments from where you're traveling to, Punta Gallina or Cabo de la Vela. I'm curious, let me know. If you're curious about the Wayuu people or you have questions about what to bring, what not bring, what to do, what not to do in Punta Gallina and Cabo de la Vela, well, there is more videos, so go check them out. I'm gonna link them somewhere. I'm also on Facebook and Instagram. You can find me, you can find me over there as Aleja Odyssey. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. ¿Tienes alguna pregunta? Por favor, déjame saber en los comentarios. Y si te gustó este video, dale like al video y compártelo con tus amigos. Suscríbete al canal también. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. This is really the hottest, the biggest adventure of my life, going to Punta Gallina. Honestly, it was. Besitos. Chao, chao. Nos vemos en la próxima.